Growing up, we would travel back and forth to church camp at my great-grandma's house, and a majority of the time, my mom would play an audiobook, and it was usually Harry Potter. In fact, I don't remember a road trip when something besides Harry Potter was played over the speakers. I would lean my head against the window, close my eyes, and fall asleep listening to the descriptions of the characters and the trials and the triumphs. In Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, Harry's name is pulled, and he must compete in three dangerous tasks for honor, eternal glory, and gold. But something was up, and Harry's life was yet again thrown through a loop. He won the tournament, well, tied, and long story short, and spoiler alert, Voldemort returns and is trying to kill Harry. Harry is surrounded by Voldemort and his followers, preparing yet again to fight for his life, and we read this. "Do nothing unless I command you," Voldemort shouted to the Death Eaters, and then an unearthly and beautiful sound filled the air. It was coming from every thread of the light-spun web vibrating around Harry and Voldemort. It was a sound Harry recognized, though he had only heard it once before in his life. Phoenix Song. It was a sound of hope to Harry, the most beautiful and welcome thing he had ever heard in his life. And I want us to focus and look at the last sentence. It was a sound of hope to Harry, the most beautiful and welcome thing he had ever heard in his life. In the moments of darkness and despair, of not knowing what's to come, there's always hope. Hope to lean into. And I ask you to lean into the idea of hope with me today. This world is already a broken place. Then throw in COVID, wildfires, no schools, the dissonance in our nation, and everything else 2020 has thrown at us. Not to mention, we completely forgot about the whole murder hornets thing and the inland hurricane that rocked Iowa. It's been rough, it's been tough, and I don't have the answers for why. But I do know one thing, I know we can hope. And although we don't have a magical bird that's going to come and save us, we have something so much better. We have our God, who is so much stronger, mightier, and powerful than a magic bird. We serve a God of hope. He is our hope. He is our light in the darkness. He is the most beautiful and welcome thing we will ever hear about. But that doesn't mean our world and this life is going to be perfect. The Book of Lamentations is just that, a book of laments, a book full of crying out to God. But in Lamentations 3 we read, "Yet this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." God is our hope with whatever disease spreads, or fires that destroy, or wars that wage against our bodies, minds, or souls. We know this. We know that God is on the throne. He always has, and he always will. This earth, these bodies, they aren't forever, but we serve a God who is. So have hope in that, knowing that this dark tunnel you're in, or whatever dark tunnel you might go through, there's a light at the end, and that light is our hope, and that light is the love and sacrifice of Jesus Christ.